In this video, I'm going to explain the overall structure of my game so that you don't have to watch every single video. First, the most important and basic thing is that everything goes around state machines. So here is the main character, the YBot Yellow. And this has the animator. The animator itself is a state machine, and each of these states represent a single animation. And all we're doing is transitioning from one state to another, or from one animation to another. Each state has this script that has a list of all the abilities that are associated with that state. So here we have the idle state, for example. It has the idle animation. It also has abilities for checking your keyboard presses. We also have running and walking. And there's really barely any difference between walking and running. The only difference is that we're moving forward, but we're moving at different speeds with a different animation. So they both have move forward for their ability list, but they might have different variables like speed. This is how the entire game runs. Everything that the character does is a combination of an animation and the list of abilities that are associated with the animation. And for the AI, we use the same structure of a state machine. If we look at YBot Blue, here we have the animator for the AI. And because AI is something abstract, it doesn't have an animation associated with it. It just has a bunch of different states that have different abilities. Let me get my trusty MS Paint to summarize everything. So if we have a character here, this character cycles through different animations or different animation states. We also have different parameters that gets checked or unchecked, and these parameters determine which animations get triggered and which animations you transition to. If I take a look at Unity again for a second, these are the parameters that determine which state you're transitioning to next. And every single character follows the same format. So we could have many different characters with the same structure. And the only difference between a playable character and the AI is that these parameters for the player are determined by your keyboard, and for all the other characters, they're determined by AI. So that was everything in a nutshell. If you understand this design, you've pretty much understood the entire project. So that'll be it for this video. Thanks for watching, and have fun making games.